This is the 354 floor plan for Postwood. I'm Shannon Washburn. I'm a salesperson for the company. And we're going to go through here and take a look at elevation A. Note the elevation is the architectural rendering of the front of the house. And it changes the windows, shutters, shapes of the brick, and placement of garage doors. Note you can change this from a double door to a single door. There is an upcharge. There's a standard landscape package. Your yard is sodded all the way to the corners of the fence. The fence comes standard to the back corners of the house. This house has an exterior accent paint. It's called earthy ochre. And the front door is a standard front door with a brushed nickel handle there. The address block and coach lights have been added as an upgrade. The shutters color is chocolate eclair, and this looks like maybe an old colonial Nottinghamish kind of brick color here. Very traditional. There is a porch that comes out to the side of the house here. I recommend if you have dogs or kids that you want to keep in the backyard that you pull the fence up to include this. And we'll look at this from the other side. Gutters have been added to the front of this house. They are not standard. There are no gutters that are standard on the front of the house. You got electrical here. Doorbell standard. Tile is standard in the entryway. Try to show the transition here. And looking up, depending on the elevation, will change the front of this room. Got a standard light here, and you've got some railing for the upstairs. You can change this to spindles. If you want to change it to wrought iron balusters, we can get that priced out. This top part up here, though, does not have an option for a standard, all of it to be spindles. However, we can price it per linear foot, depending on what you're wanting to do. This is the back of the front door. This huge, huge window here. The garage is right here. It's standard to be a flat door because per code, it cannot have texture or any sort of undulations in it. That's a safety violation. Okay, my night vision is not working in here as much as I would like to show it to you. There's a little bit of storage space, probably half the garage worth. It goes back probably about 5 feet. The breaker box is in here. Also the pre-warm wire for the alarm, so when you come into the house, you can turn it off here. As you come into the house, the powder bath is under the stairs. It comes standard with this pedestal sink and mirror. If you're planning on elongating any toilets, the powder is the most used bathroom in the house. I definitely advise doing that. Standard carpet installed here. You can add an arch for a small charge. This is a standard chandelier. This is set up as a media room. You can put doors on it. You can change the location of the entrance. Some people change it to where the entrance is on this side, where you come in the front door, so it's more like a formal living instead of having it on the back side. But that's totally up to you. Any extra cable plugs and things that you want put in different places or pre-wires, we can absolutely do that for you. We charge per drop, but you just got to tell us where to put them at. This has an optional island that you can put in here. You can add taller cabinets like these. Tile has been added in here, and then this is a standard countertop color. This is a laminate, looks like granite. And this is a standard flooring. This is also a vinyl. You can do tile. Flooring is the one thing we recommend if you're tight on your budget. Flooring is cosmetic. We recommend that be the last thing you upgrade because it can always be done after close. Okay, walk-in pantry, light. These cabinets do not come with under cabinet lighting. That's something you would have to add. This is a standard sink. If you're going to do an undermount sink, you'd need to do a granite or a solid surface such as the Tresca. And then there's an upcharge for that. The upcharge is the same right now for both sinks. There's a 50-50 and a 60-40. We're going to take a look at this backyard here. This house is interesting because it has an interesting shape to the backyard. Okay, the house has an angle to it, which gives it a little bit more space back here. Now, the standard is that there is power, there's a light here, and then there's a 3x3 patio here. I would highly recommend making a bigger patio back here if it's in your budget. You can also add a floodlight up here or on the back of the house, and then you've got a water spigot that's standard over here. You can extend your fence up so you go further up the side of the house if you want to, if you need a little bit more running space. Just note that if you bring it up in front of those windows right there, that your dining room is going to be staring at fence instead of the brick of your neighbor's house. Note how this is arched here. You can also do an arch here. This plan has two areas for porches. This is our old fireplace. We now have a cast stone fireplace that you can do as an upgrade. As soon as I get that, I'll post it on the website so you can see that and pictures of it. This is done as a wall switch, so you can start it by clicking this switch right here. It's gas, it's hardwired into the house. Never have to get fuel for it, just pay your gas bill. All right, standard covered porch. Recommend adding a ceiling fan pre-wire out here. So in the hot Texas summer, spring or fall, you can have some nice cool air flowing and you don't ever have to forget that you left your fan outside. You can concrete this in if you want to. This has been left as grass. We're happy to add more exterior plugs if you want to. You can extend your fence from the back to the front. Note that the AC unit will be set somewhere along this side, but that would then extend your space up here. I recommend not doing it from the gas meter in case you need any kind of servicing. There's a little light out here, electric. Another arch you can do is here, going into the master bedroom. Note the door isn't directly on the living area. However, the AC ventilation system is set up just outside of it. Windows going to the outside on that angled area out there. I wish I could try to get some better scale here. This is an enormous room. If you want a two-story with the biggest master, this is an enormous room. You have plenty of room for a sitting area. There's cable that's standard in here. It's all the bedrooms are pre-wired for ceiling fans on two switches. Standard separate tub and shower with the window here. You can upgrade to a jacuzzi if you want to. You can also frost the glass on the shower if you need some more privacy. The commode room is separated by a door from the rest of the bathroom. It's important at this price point. Most of them are open and right next to the tub. Standard flooring is vinyl. This is the standard transition. We can do vinyl all the way across or we can add tile. Standard two vanity sinks, and there's an area to sit there, do your hair, your makeup, take five. And then you have a really good size closet in here with a standard built-in. This is a good size closet. Once again, this is hard to show on video. doing my best. Wah. Got your home run for your security system in here. Now we're gonna head upstairs. Just gonna try to get this some scale. Huge room, high ceiling. Going towards the front. By the way, if you do have it in your budget or at some point to do this in tile, rooms and houses look so much larger if you can do tile or the same surface all the way into this area here. All right, upstairs. Game room. Huge room. Got one window here. We could wall it in and do an upstairs media room if you wanted us to. Not a problem. Some extra plugs have been added up here. You have one bathroom upstairs. You can do it as a single sink or you can do it with double sinks. Just depends if you think whoever's upstairs is going to need a second sink or not. Standard tub and shower. All right, we got the linen closet for the bathroom right here. Then on this side, we've got the laundry. The cute little picture window in this elevation. It's actually big enough to put a basket on. Standard built in here. Mana Block PEX plumbing system. Your breaker box for all your water coming into the house. Pre-plumbed for gas or electric dryer. A lot of people like to use gas for the dryer because it's extremely energy efficient. And there's one bedroom over here. Note the bedroom has a walk-in closet, and this house has added the light outside of the closet. That's not standard. All right, two bedrooms on the other side. So one downstairs. We've looked at one so far upstairs. These are the other two. So this is standard as a four bedroom. 2.5 bath. Sliding closet here. Now this bedroom will change with the windows depending on the elevation that you choose. Sliding doors. And a little half door going out here. Ow. Okay, that wasn't the best idea. But this is the attic space. I'd show you it if I had enough light, but I can't. That's probably why there's a lock on here. In any case, once again, this is the game room. So there's a game room downstairs right here. There's a media room. And then you have that outside covered porch. So those are some nice adds in addition to the bedrooms. And I will post with this and the link to the floor plan on the website. Please be sure and visit me at pride-home.com. My name is Shannon Washburn, and let me help you plan your next house.